even though you were charged earlier and been pardoned, it's still sitting there.
With Canada's new no wait, no fee pot pardon process now in effect, some are saying the new legislation is far from enough. If you plan on crossing the U.S. border, even with a pardon, simple marijuana possession charges could still stand in your way.
When they ask you, have you been charged, or, you know, do you have a record? And of course, you know, you got to tell them the truth. They can bring it up as well. You're pretty well pooched. You won't be able to get into the United States if you want.
Canadians can now apply for pot pardons online through a streamlined process with no waiting periods and no $631 fee. The federal government made the announcement August 1st, saying the new system will make it easier for people to go to school, work, and travel. But some advocacy groups are calling for those records to be expunged completely.
Expunging that, well, it's not even recorded anymore. It's gone, completely gone off the record.
In a statement, U.S. Customs Border Patrol said the United States does not recognize pardons issued by Canada. But they explained, you can be asked about previous criminal records, and those who admit to it can be inadmissible to enter the country. They said failure to respond to an officer's questions or lying in response can result in denial of admission and a ban on entry. While many Canadians think that the pardons are a good first step, some agree that more needs to be done.
They can sell alcohol and cigarettes. I don't see why not people with weeds should be chastised for it.
I mean, I think this is a good start, but yeah, like, if it's legal now, why keep harping on it? You know what I mean? Why just leave the past be the past?
Make something legal. You shouldn't, like, people who committed that crime back when it's legal, it should just get, like, reversed.
It should be done in such a way where it's a mix of pardons and expunging it.
In Montreal, Sharon Yonan-Renold, City News.